In this scenario, we'll be covering both stable and unstable tachycardia. Your patient is a conscious and alert 35-year-old male. You start by asking him how he feels, and then your primary assessment reveals that he's responsive, his airway's open, and he's breathing rapidly. The patient was at work during a very stressful day when the symptoms abruptly started about an hour ago. The patient's chief complaint is that his heart's racing, he feels dizzy, and he feels weak. Now, since my patient has not immediately life-threatened conditions, we direct a team member to get a good set of vitals. The vitals are as follows. Pulse rate is 188, respirations are 24, blood pressure is 110 over 70, skin is cool and pale, and the O2 sat is 92%. Based on the O2 sat, we need to start oxygen, and we're going to do so at 4 liters via nasal cannula. The goal is to titrate oxygen to keep an O2 sat of 94% or better. Now, after the oxygen has been started, we need to get an ECG monitor on this patient, and when the monitor is applied, we look at the monitor and see a narrow, complex supraventricular tachycardia. Since the patient's stable, we direct a team member to try vagal maneuvers first. This didn't work, so we opt for drug therapy next. We direct a team member to start an antecubital IV 18-gauge with normal saline at a TKO rate. Now that the IV is established, we decide to try adenosine 6 milligrams rapid IV push. A second dose of 12 milligrams can be given 1 to 2 minutes later if the first dose does not work and the patient is still stable. At any rate, you direct a team member to give 6 milligrams adenosine rapid IV push. Remind the team member to flush the line with 20 mLs of saline afterwards to make sure to get that right into the body. As you look at the monitor, you see that the patient is still in SVT. We direct the team member to get another set of vitals. Vitals are as follows. Pulse is still 174 and weak. Respirations are 18 and shallow with a blood pressure now of 94 over 70. The skin is cool and pale. O2 sat is 94%. As we think about getting a 12-lead EKG, the patient goes unconscious. Now that you have an unstable patient, you direct the defib team to perform a synchronized cardioversion. The patches are applied and the defibrillator is set for a synchronized shock at 50 joules. The defibrillator team member says, clear, charging, shocking at 50 joules on 3. 1, 2, 3, shock delivered. As you look at the monitor, you see a normal sinus rhythm of 80 beats per minute. The rhythm has been successfully converted. The patient becomes conscious after a few seconds, and at this time you direct a team member to get another set of vitals and continue to monitor the patient.